Deuteronomy 28. You know, that's a scripture for prosperity. So God is not against it.
Even in churches nowadays, if you don't have money, they will look at you as if you are nobody. To pay your tithe, you have to pay your tithe with money. You pay offerings, you do things in church, contributions and other things.
To make heaven, we need to preach prosperity. Because without prosperity, there's no heaven.
I once read online that some churches' teaching says that when you're poor, it means you lack faith. And when a Christian suffers, it means you haven't been taught about prosperity. I mean, who wants to be poor? But today's question is, should prosperity teachings be banned in churches, judging by the way people have started using this to enrich themselves? Come, let's ask people on the streets of Lagos. Should prosperity teachings in churches be banned?
I cannot subscribe to that. How can you ban prosperity teachings?
From inception, prosperity has been there. So you can find out that even Adam and the rest of them, they were all prosperous people.
I don't think you should be stopped. What I would say, they should impose, let me use this opportunity, they should start asking churches to pay taxes. That is my own opinion.
You know, people are suffering of poverty now. That is why they are preaching the prosperity, healing and everything.
Jesus Christ comes with everything that is good. So if the message focuses on Christ, then it's okay. But if they're focusing on prosperity, as in everything is just about prosperity, then I think there's a problem.
Bible says money has started everything. Well, we need money to do things, to do different things. Without money, even in churches nowadays, if you don't have money, they will look at you as if you are nobody. To pay your tithe, you have to pay your tithe with money. You pay offerings, you do things in church, contributions and other things.
Deuteronomy 28. You know, that's a scripture for prosperity. So God is not against it. So why should it be banned?
They are no more preaching about Christ. They are no more following Christ. What they know is what they want to eat, buy a car, build the best house in the whole world, feed themselves. They don't think that the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ is our time. What they believe, go and bring money, preaching about money.
We Christians, we are working towards to make heaven. So to make heaven, we need to preach prosperity, because without prosperity, there's no heaven.
It is just common fashion. Prosperity, they will not. It cannot take somebody to heaven. What takes somebody to heaven is salvation. When you go to a church, wherever they are preaching the real gospel, they will preach and you will understand it, rather than to preach prosperity. All these churches of nowadays, they are on one line.
He wishes us to be prosper in every area of our life. So, you know, and we are talking about prosperity. There are so many things attached to it. It has a principle. So it has to be teaching. It has to be teaching the church. They have to give room for such teaching on the church.
Prosperity is for God's children. I mean, the Bible says it's the children's bread. God's children, I mean, it's for them so that they'll be able, I mean, it will enhance them to be able to propagate the gospel very well.
I think for me, it's about looking at the foundation. Who first is the foundation? Abraham. We call Abraham a father, see? Now, why would you want prosperity teaching to be bound in church when Abraham himself is as wealthy as what's for me? Is wealth at this point I can't contain. I can't say this is the value of how what is worth.
We should be able to promote teachings in church that help us to love each other as Christ loved each other. Because everything is about love. Everything is about how Christ loved us. And the truth is, when you have all of that love, every other thing that is good is going to follow.
10 Christians now, 9 will go for that. That prosperity. That's what he's selling now.
It shouldn't be stopped. The only thing that should be done with that, it should be improved upon, but not stopping outrightly.
No, everybody want to reach. That is why they use what people want to preach to them. That is it. No salvation again. No any other thing again, but everything is prosperity now.
I think I want to be as prosperous as Abraham. Now, there are two people in the Bible. There is Lazarus, he made heaven. And there is Abraham, he also made heaven. You understand? But at the end of the day, somebody stayed in somebody's best quarter. Do you see that part? Lazarus was poor here, wretched. He went through pain. He suffers a lot of setback. But he made heaven. Thank God for him making heaven, which is ultimately our final goal, making heaven. Abraham was very wealthy, rich, influential. In fact, he took 318 soldiers to go help his brother Lot. Did you remember that? Save his brother Lot. From his house, men he groomed himself. That's how wealthy he is. Now he ended up making heaven. And Lazarus made heaven. Lazarus stayed in, was in Abraham's bosom. That was how the Bible explained it.
You've heard it all. Should prosperity teachings be stopped in churches? Yes or no? Do not forget to put your comments in the comment section and also subscribe to BatterBox. My name is Becky and thank you for watching.
BatterBox.